Good morning. As you can see, that this recording of Advar Torah for Parshat Bereishit takes place in our sukkah. So if there's any noise and fluttering of pictures and stuff, so then I hope that you'll excuse us so that it won't be much of an interference in Advar Torah. The Ramban, in one of his drashot, it was his last drasha before he went on Aliyah, he gave a drasha in Spain called Torah Hashem Tamima, which is the Torah of Hashem is perfect. And in that drasha, he explains that the book of Bereishit contains all the mysteries of Jewish thought. And therefore, when approaching this parasha of Bereishit, so we must be very careful not to take things on a simplistic level, but to take heed of what the Ramban says, that all the Sitrei Torah are encapsulated in this parasha. And in this parasha, when describing the Garden of Eden, the Torah says that the Etz HaChayim, the Tree of Life, was placed in Betoch HaGan, which means in the middle, in the midst of the midst of the garden. And this has raised people's attention, the commentary's attention. Why is this detail important to us to know that the Etz HaChayim was dafka in the middle, in the midst of the Gan, in the midst of the Garden of Eden? The Pardes Yosef says that this is an allusion to a principle that the Rambam says in his introduction to Pirkei Avot, in which he says that a person always has to go in the middle part. He always has to go in the Derech Hashem. Hashem and the Halacha describes us to be the middle path. And therefore it says that the Etz HaChayim, the Tree of Life, was dafke in the middle of the Gan of Eden. And the Rambam adds on, that at certain times we're not supposed to go in the middle path. For example, if a person steers off the track and a person wants to correct his way, he wants to do tshuva, so the Rambam says that a person then has to go to extremes. Just like when it comes to the physical body, we sometimes, a person's got a cold, so he has to have extra heat. A person's suffering from fever, he has to bring ice, and he has to bring down the temperature, he has to go to a certain extreme. So when it comes to a Baal Tshuva, a person has to go to extreme. But a person who is basically a tzaddik, he has to go in the middle path. And this is what the Tree of Life is alluding to. I'd like to just add on that maybe that's the pshat in the Gemara in Masechet Brachot that says, in a place where there are balei tshuva, tzadikim burim lo yicholim lamod sham, where in a place where there are balei tshuva, so the tzadikim cannot stand there. Some people have explained this, that the level of a balei tshuva is greater than that of tzadik. According to what the Pardes Yosef has said, and the way we've explained it now, it just means that the place of service, the place of working on oneself, of a Baal Tshuva is different. He takes the sides and the extremes. Whereas a person who's not a Baal Tshuva, he is, like the Torah says, his path is to be in the center and to follow the Etz HaChayim B'toch HaGan. Shabbat Shalom and all the best.